Don't forget to check out my Patreon, where we have exclusive content such as Camp Zero Base One, 17's Nana Tour, 17 in the Soup, Finding Stray Kids, Blackpink House, EXO's Ladder, EXO Showtime, A-Pink Showtime, and tons of other content, including extra variety shows, K-dramas, animes, and movies. Hey guys, Andrew. Today we have a lot of music videos to catch up on here. Sorry if you can hear the AC, it'll be gone for the actual video reaction. My goodness, what the fuck happened? We have Rocky's Jealousy. Mashio debuted! Finally, Mashio from Treasure. The member who left Treasure, a Japanese member. Just the two of us. Looks like it's gonna be cute. Lisa Rockstar, very curious. I'm kind of scared because I didn't really like her solo music. But better, maybe it's just gonna be better now. And then we have Empty Box with ATEEZ and Choose Strawberry Jam or something like that. So let's hop into the video. If you don't know Rockies, my bias in Astro. I'm very curious. It looks like it might be a little sexy. Oh. Is he going more vocals again? I think. Okay, the hair, let's go. Little Michael Jackson vibe. Ooh. It's like a lot of English. Oh, this chorus. She looks so familiar. She kind of looks like Sylvan. Well, this is very Michael Jackson, which I know he, I'm pretty sure he's mentioned Michael Jackson as his role model. Pretty sure. Because his dancing, a lot of his dancing and singing style is reminiscent of Michael Jackson. It's the eyelids for me. I like this way more than his other song, which I did like, but I think this suits it more. This roof does not look familiar. Really, most idols use the same roof to film, so. Let's go! Oh, this one was hard. I love this. I love this way more. Okay, this goes hard. I'm very mad Rocky doesn't get anywhere near enough attention. I know Astro are technically a tiny group, to be honest. Like, they just had a really good core fandom. But, I mean, come on, this is so good. This is very, like, this is no different from, like,
Jungkook.
But I think it's a little better, personally.
But that's just my opinion. I love BTS, by the way. That was in trade at Jungkook. That's just like, why are we sleeping on this? But I think most people just didn't hear it. So I feel like if people heard it, they would love it. And this was really good. Auroras, let's get it. Come on. Like, y'all sleeping on my boy. No, I got Mashio. I love Mashio's vocals, so. Also, I'm gonna assume it's gonna be in Japanese. So. Damn, there's no. I miss him. How about the crowd? I missed him so much. Don't look at me. Wait, why are we just doing... Is this the X members special? I'm just realizing this. Chu, Luna, Rocky, Astro, Mashi... Wow, this is the X K-pop members. Either left or quit or disband. Why would we even have Lisa in there? Because Lisa, like, is Blackpink really gonna have a comeback? I doubt it, so... They may have like one random single, but I am not holding my breath for it, so. Wonderful dance. Because he was mainly known for dancing. But obviously his unique color tone. It's cute. I like it. Very different from the last song. Oh, I just missed him. Listen, I'll eat anything up. Whatever you want, catch you. I saw a rainbow, so right. I'm just kidding, but. I'm just so happy to see Mashi. I'm also assuming these are just his friends. Like, it just seems like they just... It just feels like a cute little kind of homemade video in a lot of ways. That's catchy. I like it. It's cute. It's cute. I liked it. Yeah, I saw Yandam's album at Barnes & Noble's. I was like, oh shoot, he had a physical album. I love that. Yeah, like, I'm always just gonna be heartbroken, not gonna lie. I feel like B.I., Wonhole, and then Mashio and Yandam, those exits hurt me the most. Rocky leaving Astro didn't, nothing about that felt hurtful to me because he still,
like there's no animosity, there's nothing there that hurts me, because it feels like they're still like friends and stuff. But like, and then Wonho's is just because I'm such a, like, Wonho's hurt so much because it was just so, it was just so frustrating. And I was also, I think the day before my birthday, I don't remember, but it was around that. So, that one always hurt. But I guess similar to Rocky, Wonho was seen with Monsta X a lot after that, so there's clearly no animosity there either. I also feel like Wonho leaving Monsta X, it sounds weird, but like, it didn't affect the group too much. Like, it did, but they kind of rebuilt it very well. Like, they, once they got more control over their group and everything, I felt like, and like post-pandemic when they finally got to tour again and stuff, I felt like that rebuilt well. I also got to see them before and after Wonho, so like, I got to experience Wonho in the group and Wonho out the group. B.I.'s just was so painful because everything about that hurts, and they're not friends anymore, so that hurts, and it just makes me feel so icky. And same with Mashi and Yudam. Like, it's very clear to me they're not friends anymore, which really hurts. Like, I feel like something else happened, and not knowing just hurts a lot. Like, regardless if the leaving was, like, if them leaving, because I feel like Mashi's was more health-wise. He, like, barely danced here, too. But I've seen him dancing as a champ, so I feel like either it was a mental health thing or a physical health thing, but regardless, it's clear that he didn't want to leave. It's more like something prevented him from staying in the group physically or mentally. Like, it was like a bittersweet, like, I have to do this thing. Yudam just kind of always rubs me weird, and I don't know which side it is. I don't know if it was something because of him or something because of them. Something about it just makes me feel really unsettled. Like, it's an unknown, and that always makes me uncomfortable, but yeah, it was nice. We finally got to hear Yudam, and now we finally got to hear Mashi. So, where would the T be? What would the T be for? Well, there's TH. There's other letters. Are they all T? No, that's an. Are these just random letters? Yeah, T, H, another. I don't know what the H would be for. I feel like this, I thought maybe it could have been an Easter egg, but I mean, Mashi spoke video. Like, he's less shy of it, so I don't know. All right, I'm very curious about Lisa. I like the teaser photos. Jesus! I mean, I shouldn't be surprised. I shouldn't be surprised, but Jesus. Shoot, okay. I love this setting. Alisa, can you teach me Japanese? I said, hype, hype. That's my life. Oh, that's baby, okay. I like the hi-hi. Oh, I saw she literally filmed this in Thailand, which is like, I think is really cool. Oh, that's an ongoing line. Wait, what'd she say? Sorry. I don't know if I heard that wrong. Let me. Wait, I need to hear. I need to go. I don't know if I. I need to, I think I'm mishearing it. Lyrics. I don't it, like those. Okay. Oh, Teddy, that's why. Teddy's still here. I mean, I should have known because it's still technically. Isn't she technically still under? I'm still in damage. Make them chase them for my thrill. Been MIA. BKK. So. What? I'm sorry, I'm so ignorant. What's BKK mean? I think I get what she meant. I thought she meant something else, but now I'm like, did she mean both? Do you know the line I'm talking about? Because I don't want to like break it down. I don't want to like explain it. Like, well, this line. So I was like, oh. Oh, and I was like, wait, oh, and I was like, wait, but oh, it could be a double entendre. I feel like if it was any other group or any other singer in K-pop, I wouldn't think this hard about that. But it's Lisa, and I feel like she would go there. I feel like she. What do you guys think? Am I overthinking? It's also the way she said it. That's why I was like, whoa, did she say? And I was like, wait, it is called Rockstar, so I don't think it's. Maybe I'm overthinking that lyric. It's probably not that deep, but it really.
Rockstar is a hype, yes, no pretending type.
Oh, the
Oh,
hips.
resentin', oh shit. This a rap
Okay, well, she said,
anyway.
oh shit, so I think she did mean it that way. I think she did mean it. Okay, I really want to hear these. Her. I need to see the lyrics. Because she's talking too fast. Make a wish, babe. What you gonna do? Dipping out. Mood is like a Ponzu. I don't know what Ponzu means. Oh, is it food? I don't know. Girl, you're making me look up everything. I don't get it. Dipping out of cities like a Ponzu. Oh, because you. Dipping sauce. Okay, gotcha. Gotcha. Because I was like, what do you mean out of? And then it's the dipping. That's the joke. The dipping, not the cities. It's a fast life. It's an attitude. Put it on the counter. I want to come through. Yes, like it's funny. Yes, snow pretending. Tight dress. LV scented. Oh shit, Lisa reppin'. Okay. She deserves these breakdowns because she's actually finally able to rap properly.
It's an attitude. It's a rapping. Been on a mission, but it called me.
The
BK so pretty.
way
Everything's
she,
been up. Been in my A, BK so
like, her upper body
pretty.
barely moved. It was all
Paris,
lower
yeah,
body.
goes my city. Goes
Oh, she looks
sitting
so.
on a dash. She a dash. She a rock star.
This is my
Maybe
favorite
one
part.
thing I wanna rap. Maybe la la. Lisa, can you teach me Japanese?
And say hi, hi.
Rock
People were
star.
really freaking out over that line, but I feel like I'm either missing something or. Like, people were like, oh shit, that line went hard. Am I missing it? Am I missing why? Like, I felt like there were better lines. Is it because it's like the catchphrase of the song? Like, people were really. Like, I was like, oh, it must be like a cool bar in the song, like with context. But I feel like I'm missing an extra layer to that because it goes. Or. No, once again, I feel like I'm thinking too hard. Is it because people assume everyone who's Asian is Japanese? I don't think that's it. I don't think that's it at all. Because the rest of the song. Because I'm like. I don't. Like, I get hi hi means like yes. But like. So if you're saying yes. Lisa, can you teach me Japanese? Yes. I don't know. Maybe I'm overthinking it. Maybe it's not that deep, and people just like how she delivers it. I have to look up people's thoughts, so maybe they'll. Wait, sorry. Wow. This bit is so. Oh my god. This song's way better. Oh my god. I don't like this part that much, but it's okay. She looks so good too. She's always a grill in every music we don't know. And it looks good on no one. That's crazy. My hips broke looking at that. Least it was a star, so it actually looked cool. Some sense. Yeah, like, I would. Imagine the impact. She doesn't have to. I want to firstly say Lisa does speak pretty fluent English. She doesn't need to sing in Thai. She doesn't need to. But imagine the impact Lisa would have on the world being the number one Asian artist right now. She is number one. Like, I'm not even, like, not even BTS. Not even BTS. Not, because when people think of BTS, if I walk out on the street and there's someone around my age and I ask, name a K-pop artist, they'll likely say BTS. But if I say to name a member of BTS, they couldn't do it. But if I said name a member of Blackpink, people will usually say Lisa or maybe Jennie. One of those two. But they wouldn't be able to name a member of BTS. Now, if you ask a casual listener of K-pop, maybe they'll name Jungkook. Maybe Jungkook. But they'll never name Jin. They'll never name Suga. Yoongi. Like, they won't name him. But if someone had to guess an artist, it may take them a minute, but they'll be like, Lisa? I think there's a Lisa. They'll do that. Now, they have the advantage that Lisa is a very easy name to remember, and Jennie, they have English names, like names that are common in the English language. So there's a big advantage there, but there's RM and B, and people tend to still forget those names. So imagine if Lisa released a song that at least had some Thai in it. Like, she did Japanese before Thai. I find that kind of funny. Once again, just because you're from a place doesn't mean you need to sing in the language. I'm just saying it would be really impactful. But I don't like that people do put that pressure on Asian artists to... Because it's very... Like, I get why they do it. I get why. I just think it'd be really cool if Lisa, because even Bam Bam doesn't, does he have any songs in Thai? I think he sometimes has Thai lyrics, but even Bam Bam doesn't really do it either. Minnie sings in English a lot. Like, it's like very rare. Lisa, Rockstar. I need people to explain the Japanese line, because I feel kind of stupid. Oh, Reddit. They're calling it mid. It's mid, but it's gonna... Oh, you know, let's just expose it. I didn't want to say this, but I think this is it. But I think that's sad, you know? I think it's sad. I feel like she's slowly accepting her ethnicity. She's always been very proud of Thai things, but it's like, I don't know how to explain this. I don't really like touching people's culture and how they feel with it, because there's reasons why people, like, for example, I'm Hispanic and my mom's Hispanic, but she'll still be racist to, like, Mexican people, because we're seen as the, like, in her mind, we're seen as, like, the better than Mexican. Like, she'll still, like, be racist to Mexican people. And I think there's still, like, that connotation of, we're not those types of Hispanic. We're not loud. We're not super dark. Like, you know, like, that kind of racism. And I feel like because she lived in Korea so long, and because I guarantee she faced a lot of racism in Korea, it made her ashamed of herself. But she's embracing her darker skin tone more recently. She's not wearing bangs, which the bangs wasn't really a big thing to me, but like, I felt like that was a comfort thing for her. I do like her with the bangs, but she's beautiful without them. And I can understand, as someone who has bangs, that it's a little difficult to manage, so I don't blame her for getting rid of them. She's like, I'm sexy now, my forehead's out. I do think part of why she doesn't speak or sing in Thai is because she will always be proud to say she's from Thailand and always talk highly of Thai food. When they went to Thailand, she was very proud. But yeah, I do think she may struggle embracing that in music and when she's doing something really big. It's like she'll occasionally, like, sometimes she'll just, but that's like, that's her own journey, and I could be wrong. Like, we, I don't know. I do agree the lyrics were better than La Lisa, at least, because it wasn't as repetitive. I think the switch and flows helped the song a lot because it helped it keep you interested. I do think the lyrics are weak. Once again, it's because it's in English, though. And maybe if it was Thai, she could spit better bars and it could flow better. I actually disagree. I felt like... But Teddy still worked on the song. What do you mean? Teddy's on the song. I still don't get... Oh, that's great. Definitely my favorite of the three, though. I want to get the Lisa Japanese. Hi. See, I don't, this was the one I saw. I couldn't hear it because I purposely didn't listen, but I saw the thing, the tweet, so I knew this line was coming. But I'm, like, confused on... I don't... I don't get, like, why people... Oh... Okay, I don't know if that's true. Whatever. Let me know how you feel. Definitely the best of the three. I will listen to this one. I will actually have that one in my playlist. I think it's her best one. I think she's improving. You know, it's been 9 years. She's improving. Her voice actually sounded really good, too. I like her soft vocals. Lisa, can you teach me Japanese? I say hi, hi. Like, that'll definitely get it stuck in my head. Yes, sir. So we have to make him the main character because of his lack of lines. I never miss you. I'll never miss you. Ooh, pretty. Chino's voice in the song is crazy.
Yeah.
All right, yes, now you're done.
Miss you.
I'll never miss you. I'll never miss you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mingi's white hair with like the tint just it looks so good.
Nurture far from the bottom
of my
I'll never miss you.
Beautiful. I mean, so they catered this to me because it's my favorite song, or one of it at least. What was the beginning about? Because like, oh, he's saying that's the empty box. Like, confused. Okay. No, you know his light vocals, which is crazy. All right, last one. Strawberry Rush by Chu. Looking cute, Chu. Thank you. I feel like I haven't seen Chu with black hair. It's so. Oh, he's in the back! This little monster dude. Her videos are always so fun. Oh. Oh, I love it. I love a fun cute song. Oh, that's cool. Wait, what? This song was hard. All cute. It's very Cosmic Girl Chukume. It's like a little less camp, but like very cute, bubbly. Thank you. Very catchy. Oh, that's so cute. Okay, I think it's my favorite song from her singles. Very cute. I love that. I didn't even notice the shirt. I think also the video. Her videos are so cute. They very much make me very happy. I feel like Chu gives you life. She's very contagious in that regard. Definitely my favorite. I can't remember the names of the other songs that she did. Oh, like Howl and Aliens. I liked Aliens. And then, yeah, she has a whole EP. But that is it for this video. We've done a lot of solos, and then we have ATEEZ's Empty Box. But I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!